Full of fitness. Welcome back. This is Mobility for Runners. My co-star guest, Adam Gemili. Welcome. How are the hips feeling today?
Very tight, so this is actually going to help me quite a lot, I think. That's quite good to...
A perfect off-season.
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay, so we're going to start with your toes tucked under.
Oh no, even that I'm struggling. Let's go.
Engaging the core. Really bring those toes under your feet.
Mm-hmm.
And just sit into them. How does that feel?
Tough.
Jeez. Really?
Yeah, for me.
Look at those toes, they're like crinkles, crisps.
I'm a sprinter and my mobility isn't great, so this is actually going to really help a lot. And I try and work on this a lot, but it's pretty hard.
It's time, isn't it? So just chilling here for around 30 seconds. How's it feeling now?
Tough.
Ooh. Coming up into downward dog. And you're going to press through the right heel, holding it there, swapping sides, onto the left heel. Now pressing both heels down, coming up onto the toes, coming into a squat position, pressing through the toes, coming up into downward dog, and onto the toes again. We're going to open up the hips, so staying on the right toes, extending the left leg, opening up the hip. Really finding the openness through the fascia. Dropping the left leg down to the ground, bottom to floor. That's it.
Yeah.
Pressing up through the hips, opening up through the spine. You said you get a tight back.
Yep.
Really finding the openness. Wow. Engaging through the glutes, pressing up. Coming back through center, taking over. So coming up onto the toes again. Right leg into the air, opening up the hips. And rotate, bottom to floor, and really reach, opening up through the thoracic spine, and breathing through any little niggles. Coming back through, press up position, lowering to the count of 3, 2, 1. Okay, from here, you're gonna put your arms in a T shape.
Yep.
Is it T or tree?
Yeah.
And you're gonna take your left leg and you're gonna bring it over, just releasing the lower back and the chest.
Oh yeah, I can feel that. That's
savage on the chest, eh?
Yeah.
Woo!
Wow.
3, 2, 1. Coming back to centre. Oh, this side's a lot looser for me.
Yeah, me too, actually.
Crazy. With snowboarding, you end up, no matter how hard you try, like, one side dominant.
Yeah, are you right side forward or left side forward?
Left side forward.
Oh, wow, okay, so you're...
Coming back to centre. You mentioned the lower back.
Yeah.
This one's a good one. So you're going to clasp your hands behind your back,
mm-hmm.
engaging your glutes, pulling back your shoulders, and you're going to lift feet and shoulders off the ground.
Wow.
You're going to hold it for 10. So building strength, instability in that uncomfortable range. Woo! 3, 2, 1, and lowering. Okay, and now the all-time favorite.
Okay.
A little bit of glute action.
Okay.
So, you're gonna find your way onto your bottom.
Do you know what? I can't even cross my legs, really.
Okay, so we're gonna, again, focus on a bit of spinal twist, but also we're gonna release the glutes. So you're gonna take your left foot, and you're gonna bring it over like so, tucking that one in.
Yeah, got ya.
And this is where you hope that you haven't eaten too much food beforehand.
Well, wait a second, let's start properly and go left side, like you said.
So, nice and tall. Imagine someone's pulling you with a bit of string upright. You're gonna take your right shoulder and put it outside your left leg. And the aim is to spiral up and around. Do you feel that in the glutes?
Wow. Dang.
Breathing through that discomfort.
I think more sprinters need to get on this because
it's tough.
Yeah, it's honestly, it held me together through all of my snowboarding.
Yeah.
Yeah, like just the traveling, being on planes and stuff. Okay, and swapping sides, so you can literally open out your legs, swap them across. You may find one side is tighter than the other. So coming up, engaging the core, reaching to the sky, whoa, twisting around. Is this your tight side?
Yeah, this is the tight
one. Oh, same. The glutes.
So the thing with sprinting is you want to be flexible, but you want to have a little bit of sort of, you don't want to be too like sort of loose. You want to have a bit of elasticity as well. So it's important to stretch, and this is great for like recovery. I think this is really, really, really great for recovering after a hard running session. But that's why I'm not the most flexible.
Yeah, because it's all power and drive.
It's all power, yeah.
So if you've just done a half marathon, 5K, yeah, 10K, find a mat, get your bottom on it.
How long would you stretch for normally? An hour? Half an hour? 20 minutes?
If I'm doing a yoga session, vary from 20 minutes to an hour.
Nice.
Coming back through center, hamstrings.
Okay.
Key for runners.
Yes.
So find a nice bend in your knees. And we're just going to relax into this one. Reaching for the feet, aiming to get your chest to your legs. So you're almost going to bring your knee bend to a distance that allows your chest to rest. I'm just going to chill here for a minute. And from here you can wiggle your feet out slightly.
There you go.
Final one. Engaging the core. You're going to lower, slow, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then we're going to do a spinal twist again, which hits the glutes and lower back. So you're going to put your feet into position like so. You're going to shift your hips half a foot to the left. Right leg straight. Bring your left leg across your body.
Trying to get your knee to the floor and keep your shoulder up.
Yeah, aiming to keep your knee on the floor and your shoulder. Priority actually is the shoulder. It's very, very hard to keep both on the floor.
Yeah.
So it's something you can work towards. An option is to get a pillow, put it under the knee to support the knee, but you should be feeling this right through your hip.
Yeah, it's tight.
How does that feel?
Tight, but good actually.
And swapping sides. Again, shifting the hips the other way. Engaging the core, dropping that leg over. Feeling that stretch through the thoracic, lower back, glutes. And just breathe through this one. Okay, and now we're chilling.
Oh, let's just stay here forever because that was tough.
Full of fitness.
Oh.
That is mobility. Mobility for runners.
Yes.
How did you find it?
Good. Targeting everything you need. Lower back, glutes, hips. They're the main things that you need to be moving sort of well and mobile. So,
yeah.
No, thank you very much. That was wicked, actually.
Thank you. Full of fitness. That's a wrap. Thank you very much for joining us. Adam Gemili, everybody. World's fast man. We won't claim fastest, but...
A fast man, just a fast one.
A very, very fast man. Thank you for joining. Make sure you like, subscribe, and we will see you back next week. The series is developing. We're gonna have a new guest every week, so stay tuned.